Number 10, Mad Max 2. Also known as The Road Warrior, this sequel to the 1979 low-budget, post-apocalyptic masterpiece upped the ante and made the franchise a true cult phenomenon. A young Mel Gibson, decades before any infamous anti-Semitic ranting, solidified his status as a burgeoning superstar by once again playing a solitary drifter compelled to become a hero. Number 9, Bride of Frankenstein. Filmmakers began producing sequels at the very outset of the medium's history, and the earliest on our list is a follow-up to 1931's Frankenstein, which features perhaps the greatest movie monster ever brought to life. It's not uncommon in a second installment for a hero to get the girl, and in this instance, she has literally been dug up from the ground. It has been lauded for bringing a combination of gruesomeness, satire, and surrealism to masterpiece levels. Number 8, Toy Story 2. Toy Story, with the voice talents of Tom Hanks and Tim Allen leading a stellar cast, changed the way cartoons were made in the digital age. The 1999 sequel Toy Story 2 piggybacked on the original success, yet confidently stood out as a fantastic film all its own. Great sequel rules applied here too. Unique story, amped action, and the introduction of solid new characters. Number 7, The Lord of the Rings, The Two Towers. The Two Towers faced the challenge of connecting the grandeur of the trilogy's first installment with the climactic conclusion of its third, without possessing a clear-cut, open-and-shut story of its own. But the obstacles thrust in front of the characters and the giant scope of its special effects-heavy battles gave it all the fuel it needed to shine on its own. It became only the fifth sequel in history to win cinema's highest honor, an Academy Award nomination for Best Picture. Number 6, The Silence of the Lambs. In The Silence of the Lambs, Jodie Foster and Anthony Hopkins portray film's most fascinating frenemies. In this sequel to 1986 Manhunter, Hannibal Lecter joined the ranks of cinema's best, baddest villains, and though we probably wouldn't try his potluck offerings, he'd be one damn interesting dinner guest. Number 5, Star Trek II, The Wrath of Khan. Some fans advise that when watching the Star Trek movie series, you should skip the original entirely, due to its plodding pace and infamous decision to feature too much dialogue over action. In The Wrath of Khan, the filmmakers return to what made the television series so great: character relationships, action, and moral philosophy, and enlarge it to fit the big screen. Khan is credited with reinvigorating not only the film franchise, but the entire Star Trek universe that still lives on today. Number 4, Terminator 2, Judgment Day. The original Terminator was a low-budget sci-fi gem that launched Arnold Schwarzenegger to action hero superstardom and gave us the catchphrase, "I'll be back." In Terminator 2, he was back in a big way, this time playing the protagonist out to stop a more advanced and agile cyborg bent on changing the course of history. Influential and engaging, Terminator 2 is another shining example of a sequel done right. Number 3, Aliens. Continuing the story of Ellen Ripley, the franchise's renegade warrior, the second installment ditched the original's horror movie elements, remaking it as a war movie. The film featured an army dressed in the most powerful weaponry of the time, which nonetheless turned out to be useless against the unpredictable nature of the foreign enemy. Fast and ferocious, Aliens spun out from a masterpiece to become another all its own. Number 2, Star Wars Episode 5, The Empire Strikes Back. It's truly amazing the impact the Star Wars saga has had on the world and the lives of its legion of fans. Yet, at the same time, each film's shortcomings have also been magnified over and over under the harsh microscope of decades-long scrutiny. The Empire Strikes Back, however, separates itself as being immune from all of that. It's a perfect movie showcasing beloved characters, joined by a few new ones, caught up in a solid, unpredictable, crowd-pleasing narrative culminating in some shocking galactic twists. Number 1, The Godfather Part 2. There are few films that have raised the bar so high that they are often considered the best that have ever been made. The 1972 film The Godfather is definitely one of those. Its pace, style, and score were immensely influential, and its narrative contains one iconic film moment after the next. It would be hard to imagine that any attempt to make a sequel could reach the heights of such a significant original. But in 1974, writer-director-producer Francis Ford Coppola did just that, defying expectations with the second installment, as engaging and illustrious as the first. The Godfather Part 2 is simultaneously a prequel and a sequel, following the story of Don Vito Corleone's early rise to power and his son Michael's ascension as crime family ruler. Some argue that Part 2, the first film to designate a sequel in such a way, and the first to win a Best Picture Oscar, is actually superior to the original. We'll decline to weigh in on that argument now, acknowledging instead that it is indeed the best movie sequel ever made.